What if you always ended your fast just before the real benefits begin? A bit like taking a cake out of the oven 5 minutes too early. On the outside, it looks ready, but inside, it's still soft. Fasting is the same. And today, I'm going to reveal the exact timing your body's waiting for to launch its most powerful cleansing process, autophagy. Stay until the end, because I'll also share three concrete signals your body may send you when autophagy truly kicks in. Crucial signals that most people completely overlook. But first, let's ask the burning question. After how many hours of fasting does my body really start to clean up? 16 hours? 24 hours? 48 hours? The answer might surprise you. But before we dive in, if you like content like this, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe, and leave a boost. Let's go. First things first, what is autophagy? Imagine your body as a house. Every day you live in it, cook in it, move around, and dust piles up. Broken things gather in the corners. Old stuff takes up space. Cobwebs form in dark spots. At first you don't notice anything. Everything seems to work fine. But week after week, month after month, clutter builds up. The house becomes heavy, crowded, less efficient. Now imagine there's a built-in cleaning service, an automatic system that activates when the right conditions are met. A system that knows exactly what to keep, what to throw out, and what to recycle. That's exactly what autophagy is, the ultimate cellular spring cleaning. The word comes from Greek. Auto means self, and phagy means to eat. Literally, your cells eat themselves. Wait, wait, before you panic, let me explain. Your cells aren't becoming cannibals. Number, it's much smarter than that. They don't devour the healthy parts. They precisely target damaged proteins lying around worn-out mitochondria, your tiny power plants. Viruses and bacteria hiding inside your cells. Accumulated cellular debris. It's like your cells have an ultra-sophisticated recycling system. They take what's broken, break it down, and reuse the materials to build brand new structures. Japanese scientist Yoshinori Osumi won the Nobel Prize in Medicine in 2016 for deciphering this mechanism. This isn't pseudoscience, it's hard biology. So now the crucial question, how long do you need to fast to activate this cleaning machine? The magic timing or not? If you search online, you'll find all sorts of answers, but which one should you trust? Here's what the science actually says. Phase one, 12 to 16 hours, the awakening. After about 12 hours of fasting, your body starts to deplete its glycogen stores, the sugar stored in your liver and muscles. At this stage, autophagy begins to wake up, but like a cold engine on a winter morning. It coughs, sputters, but isn't running full speed yet. Phase two, 16 to 24 hours, acceleration. Here's where it gets interesting. Your body shifts into light ketosis, starting to burn fat for fuel. And guess what? Autophagy ramps up. Studies in mice show measurable increases of autophagy markers in the liver and brain. But here's the catch. In humans, timing varies depending on several factors I'll explain in a moment. Phase three, 24 to 48 hours, peak efficiency. This is the premium zone. Autophagy is running full throttle. Your cells are recycling intensely. Studies show this is when the neurological benefits are most pronounced. Production of BDNF, the brain protective growth factor, rises significantly. Phase four, beyond 48 hours, advanced territory. Autophagy continues, but caution. Beyond 48 to 72 hours, you're entering prolonged fasting territory, which requires supervision, especially if it's your first time. It's not for everyone and definitely not without preparation. But here's the problem. These numbers are averages, and that's where it gets fascinating, because your neighbor might trigger autophagy at 14 hours, while you might need 20. Why? The answer will show you why you must stop blindly copying what others do. Why you are unique. Listen carefully, because this is where most fasting videos let you down. Your autophagy timing depends on several factors. One, your basal metabolism. Think of your metabolism like a car engine. Some people have a Ferrari engine. They burn through fuel fast. Others have an economy car engine, slow and steady. Fast metabolism, you'll deplete sugar stores in 12 to 14 hours. Slow metabolism, it may take 18 to 20 hours. Fair or not, that's how it works. Two, your physical activity. The more athletic you are, the more fuel you store in your muscles and liver, like having a bigger gas tank. Work out intensely 5 times a week, you have an extra large tank. It'll take about 18 to 20 hours to empty. Couch Netflix lifestyle, small tank. You'll trigger autophagy around 14 to 16 hours. Ironically, being sedentary has a small advantage here. 3. Your usual diet. Imagine your body like a hybrid car. It can run on gas or electricity, but it has a preference based on habit. Eat lots of pasta, rice, bread daily. Your body's a sugar addict. Switching to fat-burning mode takes more effort and time. Already low carb? Boom. Your body flips into autophagy like changing TV channels. Easy and fast. 4. Your age and metabolic health. Bad news. As you age, your natural autophagy system rusts a bit, like an old machine starting up more slowly. Good news, that's exactly why fasting becomes your best ally after 40. It wakes up that sleeping system. The catch? If you have blood sugar issues or insulin resistance, your body takes a bit longer to switch to cleaning mode. But it will get there. 5. Your fasting experience. It's like learning to swim. The first time you sink, you panic. It's hard. First fast, your body stresses out. Hey, where's my food? It resists. That's normal. But after several regular fasts, the magic happens. Your body learns. It becomes flexible. It flips into autophagy faster and faster, like a light switch. Scientists call this metabolic flexibility. I call it turning your body into a well-oiled machine. The more you fast, intelligently, the easier it gets. It's one of the rare areas where experience truly gives you a superpower. So no, there isn't one magic number. There's your number. But wait, how do you know if you personally have entered that autophagy zone? Because we don't all have a medical lab in our living room, right? Luckily, your body speaks to you, and it sends signals impossible to miss once you know how to recognize them. 3 signals your body is in autophagy before we dive in. Remember, autophagy is an invisible cellular process. You can't measure it without biopsies or biomarkers. What I'll share are indirect but powerful wild clues that your body is probably cleaning house. Here are 3 concrete signals. Signal 1, mental clarity. You know that moment when suddenly your brain switches from foggy to laser sharp? It's not magic. Sure, this clarity is mostly linked to ketosis. Autophagy in the brain is likely happening in this context, but hard to prove without imaging. What you feel is a good indicator, but not direct proof. You stop thinking about food, you're hyper-focused. Your brain is also cleaning house, clearing out misfolded proteins, toxic aggregates, cellular debris that normally slow down neural transmission. It's like cleaning your house's electrical wiring. Everything works better, faster, more clearly. Result? That exceptional mental clarity you feel isn't in your head. It's your brain working at full potential, freed from waste and fueled by premium energy. Signal 2, slightly different breath. Sounds odd, but many people notice a metallic taste or a slightly different breath. That's acetone, one of the ketone bodies produced when you're burning fat. Not glamorous, but a sign your body has switched modes. In other words, when you notice this change, it means your body has fully moved from glucose to fat mode. That's the biochemical confirmation you're in ketosis, and likely autophagy is active too. Pro tip, if this breath bothers you, drink more water. It helps dilute and eliminate acetone, but don't see it as a problem. It's your metabolic badge of honor. Signal 3, stable energy without hunger. At the start of fasting, you may feel dips in energy, stomach growls, but when autophagy really starts, it's as if your body finds a steady energy source. No more roller coasters, just calm, stable energy. Hunger naturally decreases. Here's why this stable energy is the proof autophagy is likely happening. When your body produces lots of ketones, it simultaneously activates autophagy. The two processes are tightly linked because autophagy requires precisely that metabolic state, low insulin and circulating ketones. Check all 3 boxes, high chance you're in the zone. The mistakes that sabotage autophagy. You can do everything right, fast for 24 hours, feel all these signals, and still sabotage your autophagy with a few simple mistakes. Mistake 1, the innocent coffee. Think your coffee with a splash of milk doesn't break your fast? Think again. Even a small insulin spike blocks autophagy. Black coffee, okay. Creamy coffee, no. Artificial sweeteners? Some trigger an insulin response anyway. Keep it simple. Mistake 2. Chronic stress. Fasting 20 hours but stressed out all day? High cortisol can blunt some of autophagy's benefits. Fasting isn't punishment. Do it calmly. Mistake 3. The rebound feast. Breaking your fast with a 2,000-calorie refined carb feast? You've just canceled part of the benefits. Refeeding should be gradual and smart. Quality protein, veggies, healthy fats. Mistake 4. Fasting too often, too long. Autophagy is amazing, but your body also needs building phases, not just cleaning. Fasting 48 hours every day? Number. Your body needs nutrients to rebuild after cleaning. Your personal action plan. So practically, what should you do? For beginners, start with 16 to 8, 16-hour fast, 8-hour eating window, for 2 to 3 weeks. Let your body adapt. Watch your signals. Then test a 20 to 24-hour fast once a week. Notice how you feel. This is when many people really sense autophagy effects. For intermediates, alternate between 16 to 8 on weekdays and a 24 to 36-hour fast once a week or every 2 weeks. This rhythm optimizes autophagy without draining you. For advanced, explore 48 to 72-hour fasts once a month, always listening to your body. But consult a health professional if you have medical conditions. Universal tips: hydrate, water, green tea, black coffee. Autophagy creates waste that must be flushed out. Move gently. A walk is enough. No need for CrossFit during a 36-hour fast. Sleep. Autophagy is most active in the brain during sleep. Listen to your body. If you feel truly unwell, you don't need more willpower. You need wisdom. Conclusion. Now you know the question, how long should I fast for autophagy? Doesn't have one answer. It has your answer. For most people, the optimal zone is between 18 and 36 hours. But you must experiment, observe, adjust. Autophagy isn't a fad. It's a survival mechanism your body has had for millions of years. Our ancestors didn't eat 3 meals a day plus 2 snacks. They alternated between abundance and scarcity. Your body knows how to do this. Intermittent fasting and autophagy aren't about suffering. They're about reconnecting to this ancestral wisdom. So next time you fast, don't just watch the clock. Listen to your body. Watch for those signals and let your cells do what they're programmed to do. Clean, renew, strengthen. Now I have a question for you. What's your experience with fasting? After how many hours do you feel those autophagy signals? Share in the comments. I'm genuinely interested in your personal timing. And if this video taught you something new, don't forget to like and subscribe. The more of us understand how our bodies really work, the better we can take care of our health. This content is informational and not a substitute for medical advice. If you have specific health conditions, consult a professional before experimenting with prolonged fasting. See you very soon, and happy fasting.